So why don't you tell us your name, who you are, etc., etc.
I am David Marquez, and I am going to be the artist on Volume 2 of Days Missing, also called Days Missing Kestis.
How did you get involved with this ragtag group of people?
Well, I was already working with RK on another book called Syndrome, and as that wrapped up, I was just looking for some work, and as it turned out, Days Missing about started Volume 2, and I was available, and apparently everyone liked my work, and so given the opportunity, I hopped right on it.
Beautiful. And what was it like working with the very talented Phil Hester?
Phil Hester, it's amazing working with a writer who's also an artist. And so oftentimes in reading through the script, it's very clear that he's thought visually about how it's going to work. And so while working with you know, all the writers I've worked with have been fantastic, it's definitely a unique experience when they have insight into the process on both sides.
Go ahead.
Oh, and also just the stories themselves are really exciting, getting to draw a whole bunch of different time periods, and designing a new character, Kes, has been a lot of fun, as well as drawing a really awesome-looking character in the Steward.
But did you read the first series?
Absolutely. I read it even before I was told I was going to be working on Days Missing. So it's kind of cool. And interestingly enough, Fraser Irving and I have been friends for a few years. And so when I heard, you know, opportunity possibly to jump on a book that a friend of mine had worked on, pretty awesome opportunity.
Some pretty awesome cover artists that are working on the book. What's it like to work on books with those kind of covers?
Well, when I heard that Alex Ross is going to do a cover, I kind of, you know, did a little flip. You never imagine, most artists never imagine that you'd have an Alex Ross cover, much less when still pretty early in your career. So that's pretty awesome. Ryan Benjamin, big fan of. Dale Keown's coming back, and that's really exciting. Jorge Molina is going to be doing a cover, and that's really cool. So yeah, a really great stable of artists.
And what was it like tackling Kestis, creating a new character for us, and then, you know, kind of following the footsteps of Dale and kind of the style of the Steward?
Well, I mean, Dale and all the artists on Volume 1 did a really good job of laying down a solid groundwork for what the Steward looked like. And so it's a really cool-looking character and pretty, you know, right up the line of what I like drawing anyway. So the Steward, it's intimidating having to follow in those footsteps, but at the same time, it's a solid character, and so there's lots of guidance as far as how to draw him. As far as designing Kestis, again, I was given a lot of guidance. Trevor Roth, the creator of Days Missing, gave me lots and lots of reference and detailed descriptions of how she looked, and then just a couple rounds of drawings really quickly kind of, you know, fell on this kind of cool Bridget Fonda almost look. And no, it's been exciting, but also, again, it's always been a collaborative team effort, and I really enjoy that part of it.
And the second series, are you bringing anything else like new and exciting to it, style-wise?
Well, I mean, I work entirely digitally, and so that gives me a really good opportunity to really kind of draw heavily on certain kind of 3D programs that I use to kind of flesh out the environment. It's really cool, like building the Library of Alexandria for issue 2. That's going to be really kind of fun. But for the most part, it's just a matter of learning as much as I can about each time period and trying to sell that as well as possible for each book.
Awesome. And can you tell us a little bit about the box that you drew?
So the box is the Steward's little kind of mysterious, almost like Hellbringer kind of ornate steampunk kind of box. And this is another case where, again, working digitally was really helpful. I had a 3D model and needed to tweak that a little bit. I ended up designing the whole box in a digital format, so every time I need to draw it, I can basically take this really ornate design and manipulate it so that it looks in proper perspective, and it's much more intricate without eating up tons and tons of time. So it's a cool design, really cool concept behind it, and I hope everyone likes it.
And what's it like working with Roddenberry?
Roddenberry, it's a dream come true. I mean, I was, you know, watching Star Trek and reading Star Trek comics since I was a little kid. I grew up while, you know, Next Generation was on, so I've really kind of been immersed in that world my whole life. And now actually getting to work with Roddenberry, it's really surreal. Got to meet Rod at the con this year, and that was really exciting, really nice guy. Overall, it's been both overwhelming because of just the crazy geekiness and fanboy that wants to come out of me. At the same time, everyone is so nice that I feel at home. So it's been an absolutely amazing experience.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Dave.
Absolutely. Thank you.
We'll see you next time.